Hi, I'm Noelle Randall, and on today's episode, I'm talking to you about how to make money with your own property, buying a house for yourself. We call it homestead investing. This is a great way to get started with your portfolio, with a house that you live in. I'm gonna tell you all about it, how to do it, how to make big profits. Let's go. Hi, this is Noelle Randall.
Great news for real estate investors.
How would you like to be a boss? I'm going to show you how. Buy houses using a credit card. So let's talk about wholesaling now. Welcome back. I'm Noelle Randall, real estate entrepreneur, mentor, and mom of five. And on today's episode, we're talking about homestead investing. This is basically where you buy a house for yourself as a primary residence, you fix that house up, and then you sell it, okay? So this is how and why Noelle moves all the time, okay? I homestead invest too. So yeah, there's properties that people live in, you know, my tenants and stuff like that, but of course, Noelle and her family need somewhere to live too, and you can make money even doing that. And actually, I've gotten some really big paychecks on my own house, and I'm gonna tell you how. So let's talk through this. So let's first go through off-market properties, because I told you about property problems. You know that everything that we do and how we make so much money is by marketing and targeting people with property problems. So I'm finding people that are behind on their mortgage, someone died, home is burnt down, flooded out, got sick, whatever the situation, they have a problem and I am their solution. So let's talk about how you can make this an advantage for yourself, okay? And what I do. So I'm already marketing to these people, tired landlords and divorcees and bankruptcy people and foreclosures or whatever the situation, whatever your target niche is, okay? Or maybe you have several and you're marketing to these people and they call you and they have problems and they're ready to sell their property. Great. Start marketing in an area that you know is appreciating, of course. We'll talk about that. You don't want to do like new construction or anything like that. And you want to get a good deal. So off-market properties, getting them at a discount, all right? So we're marketing to people, just using this as an example. We come across a house that's not too old. Maybe it's built in 2000 or 2004. You know, maybe needs a little bit of updating, but still a pretty good house. Now, we're not, I don't necessarily fix and flip houses that are built in the 70s and the 60s for me to live in. Those are going to be properties that I go ahead and just fix and flip. But if it's for me and my family, I usually probably do try to find a house that's a little bit older, okay? You don't want to get a house that's too old, but you also don't want to get a house that's too new and needs some updating and is in an area that is appreciating, okay? So I'll probably make a whole video on what that means, because this video will go forever if I kind of explain that, but I think you've gotten that from my other videos, that you're looking for properties that are in highly appreciating areas and you want to find off-market properties by targeting people with property problems, okay? So we got that part. Now the second part is we're gonna buy those homes and we're gonna live in them and we're gonna fix them up. So step one, when you're buying a house for yourself, you can get almost 100% financing in most cases, okay? Because lenders see this as lower risk. So fixing and flipping, investment properties, things like that, those are considered higher risk for lenders. So that's often where they want you to put more money down, or the interest rates are really high, like hard money loans, or even with private money, they don't want to lend it for a long time, only maybe 6 months or a year. But when you're buying a house for yourself, you can just get most mortgages. You can get FHA, you can get a 100% financing loan, you can get a conventional loan, you can get a loan that is for most people. All right. And most people will qualify, or it's pretty easy to, especially with what we kind of got going on in 2019, where there's a lot more products and programs available that weren't available before that allow you to borrow 100% of the home's value, provided you're going to live in the property. Okay. So that is the key. These are for primary residences. So let me quickly tell you. So you get a loan with 97 to 100% financing. I know that's a little bit scary for some people because they're like, wait a minute, if I borrowed the whole amount, then how do I have any equity? We answer that in the first part where I told you, you're not gonna just buy any property. You're only going to buy a property that is off market, someone with a property problem that you can get a discount on. So let's give you an example. You find a house, it's worth $200,000, but for some reason they're behind on the payments, and so they're willing to kind of let it go for $150,000 or $160,000, all right? So not really this whole big fix and flip, you know, your numbers might not work for that, but this is a great home that you could live in, especially if you don't already have a home, okay? And you're like a first-time home buyer. To me, this is the only way a person should be buying their first home. Like, knowing what I know now, this is the way to buy a house, okay? And again, there's subprime loans now, there's FHA loans, where they lend you the money to buy the house and to fix the house up, okay? So they're called 203K loans, FHA rehab loans. Conventional has that as well, where they home style or home renovation loans, where you can buy the property, they loan you all of the money to buy the property, and they loan you the money to renovate the property. If you need more information on that, please, I'll put a link below for one of my lenders that does this, and she's amazing. But again, if you're serious, please don't, you know, just start calling her and texting and applying and wasting time. I want you to really be serious, okay? But I'm gonna go through the whole thing. So you can get between 97 and 100% financing, okay? You're gonna be living in the property. And you rehab the property as you're living in it. So rehab it over the course of a year, over the course of 2 years, all right? And you can use the rehab money from that first loan, or you can get a line of credit, or you can use some of your business credit cards that we've talked about how to get, and you're using that money. So again, this is important though, because you do want to fix the home up so that you can add even more value to it. You do want to renovate the bathrooms and the kitchens, or tear out the carpet and put new floors in, or, you know, you want to actually flip the house that you're living in. Okay, make it look nicer. So an example I gave you got a $200,000 house for $150,000. You put, you know, $15,000-$20,000 in it. You owe $170,000, but you've brought the value up to $220,000-$230,000. And this is how we walk away with those $70,000 and $80,000 checks after just owning a home for a year or two that we lived in. You buy the house off market, below market value, you fix it up while you're living in it, get 100% financing, get 97% financing, I don't care, because you have the equity from how you bought it, okay? So where people are trying to get equity with down payment, that's not really that smart to me, because, all right, if I buy a house and it's $200,000, I put $40,000 down, yeah, I have $40,000 in equity, but that was just my $40,000 that I put down, so that's not really equity. That's not really new money. But if I got a house and it was worth $200 and I got it for $50, that's real money. That's intangible, because when I sell it, I'll get it. But that's equity. That's money. That's $50,000 right there. Fix the property up, increase the value. Now I'm really cooking, okay? And I've done this several times, and the minimum that I've netted selling my own personal home was $56,000. The last one, it was almost 90. So these are real numbers, people. This is not hard to do. This is how you do it. And you're living in the property, you already have to pay rent or mortgage somewhere. Might as well be building that equity and getting those coins, okay? All right, number three. When you're rehabbing the house that you're living in, I told you, you don't have to do this all at once. You can do this slowly, one bathroom at a time or whatever. But you need to also use below market prices on supplies, okay? So here we go. No Home Depot, no Lowe's, you know, no Ace Hardware for the most part. You're gonna be at builder outlet stores and secondhand stores and where the builders go, okay? And you wanna get wholesale prices on even your materials and things like that. Even if you have someone else doing the work, you do not wanna pay retail prices for your rehab. And you also don't want to call a contractor that is used to doing these expensive residential rehabs for people, because you are still thinking like a real estate investor. You are still flipping this house even if you're living in it. So be really, really clear that you're going to use that same mindset. I cannot overpay for paint. I cannot overpay for carpets. I'm going to be, you know, if you're in Dallas, you're going to be on Harry Hines, you know, in Houston, I'm over in that area off in the cut, you know, when I'm in, you know those areas where all the contractors go and where you find wholesale prices and where the builders and the contractors go to buy their stuff, to buy their carpet, to buy their furniture, to buy their all of their supplies, okay? So if you don't know where these places are, you need to Google them. They are builder outlet stores. These are where builders do secondhand supply stuff or secondhand things, or sometimes they may have bulk things. Like, I'll give you an example of one of that I use a lot. There's builders like, you know, DHR Horton or whatever, the big builders and Pulte and all of them. Okay, so they buy their things in bulk. All right. And a lot of times they buy them in containers, like these big shipment containers of stuff. Like they may buy like 1,000 toilets, you know what I mean? And then they built a whole subdivision. And so at that point, they may have 22 left over and they'll sell them. And we go to those stores and we buy them. So sometimes most of the time you find some really good deals there. But sometimes, just being honest with you, they may have only one of this, or they may have a half of thing of tile. So there's some great deals there, but know that you may not have your whole house with this same tile. It may be this bathroom has this tile and then the other bathroom has a different tile because you got those tiles for like $100. But whatever, make sure it's coordinated, make sure it's nice. I'll give you some photos of kind of how I do that with some of my properties, where there's things that may be mismatched, but no one would even know because I've kind of hit it really nicely. But the key to this is buying from those builder supply stores and those secondhand stores to save a lot of money on your renovation, okay? And then the final step when you're all done with this is sell the property, okay? You cannot get used to and fall in love with your home and I don't want to leave. You got to sell it. And know when you bought it, you were selling it. You basically bought that house to sell that house in a year or two. So don't forget that that's your goal and that you're going to be doing it and you're going to have to move. So it's another thing too. I am not a pack rat. I don't keep a bunch of stuff. I don't hoard because I'm moving a lot. So if you're a person that hoards and keeps a lot of stuff and stays places for 20 and 30 years, this may not work for you. But if you, especially my millennials, you guys love this idea and you don't have a bunch of crap and you don't want to keep moving a bunch of crap, this is perfect for you and how you can make a lot of money. And this is how I have friends that really don't even work all year. They may sell their house and not work for months, okay? Because if you get a check for 80 grand, if you're smart, you don't have to work, okay? You don't have to work. You can use some of it, buy another house, and then do the same thing again. So that's this week's lesson. Hope you got all of this on homestead investing, how you buy homes that you're going to live in, fix and flip, and then sell. Now, the key, of course, we don't want to commit mortgage fraud. You do want to move into the property. So that's the caveat to this. So I need you to like this video. If you like this information, I'll keep sharing and telling you different ways to make money. Go ahead and comment below if you have any questions about anything that I said. Remember, I read all of the questions and we comment and I reply back to you. And of course, please subscribe to my channel so that I can keep bringing you this great content, keep pouring into you and teaching you everything that you need to know to be successful in real estate investing. All right, this is Noelle Randall and I'll see you next time.